So what we found is that patients, people who had E. coli infections in their blood, so they've had a urinary tract infection that's led to a blood infection, 25% of them had a large amounts of antibody that bound the bacteria and actually protected the bacteria from killing. So this is the complete opposite of what antibody normally does. Additionally, we also found that a lot of these strains isolated from the blood in normal conditions could be killed by blood. So it seems that this antibody allowed the bacteria to get into the blood in the first place. Yeah, so antibodies are normally really good for you. So they are specific for the bacteria and they bind to the outside of the bacteria, and that sort of tags the bacteria for killing by a whole variety of different methods in the body. So the research is useful for two reasons. The first is that normally it's the bacteria and something they're producing that makes them serum resistant. This is a new mechanism that actually uses your own body, so you wouldn't actually know by looking at the strain itself, that helps the bacteria survive in the blood. And the fact that it's 25% of patients means that it is it's very high prevalence. The second is that this seems to be not just relevant, these antibodies, to just E. coli, but a whole bunch of other bacteria like Pseudomonas or Salmonella that also produce this O antigen. So what we found in this sepsis case is also true in some lung infections and probably a whole bunch of other bacterial infections as well. So the first sort of easiest thing to do is we can develop a diagnostic test that will screen for presence of this antibody. So some people unfortunately get what's called recurrent urinary tract infections, and it's these patients that may be at risk of developing this antibody, and then that leads to sepsis. So if you could have a diagnostic test that would screen for this bad antibody, you could sort of see if they're going to be at a higher risk of causing sepsis. And the second part is you may be able to develop ways to either remove this antibody or inactivate the antibody that allows the host system to kill the bacteria themselves. So in this cases where antibiotic resistance are becoming more and more of an issue, this actually allows the human to kill the bacteria in the sort of normal ways that this happens without the use of antibiotics.